It is with a deep sense of honour, if not with a certain degree of trepidation, that I come to this rostrum today. You see, next year, 2009, will, God willing, mark my personal 50 years membership of this institution. And even though I have addressed orange demonstrations and gatherings before now, this is the first time I've been introduced as a special guest or as a so-called keynote speaker. Keynote speakers on occasions like this are supposed to have something important to say, something new to impart, something useful and exhilarating to deliver. And I can only hope to fulfill a very small fraction of those aims. I have actually addressed this demonstration before, way back in the early 90s when bringing greetings from my private and district lodge. And of course I have been present here at the Rosnilo Twelfth on several occasions in recent years. As I reflected on my thoughts for today, I could not help but think of changes which have happened to this and surrounding this institution over, say, the last two decades. Changes that have been somewhat interesting, if not in some cases quite astonishing. The geographical mecca for our members must be the Boyne Valley, somewhere between Oldbridge and Rosnaree, looking southwards towards the Nore Hill. For over three centuries, it has been hailed in history, in folklore, in cultural tradition and commemoration as a decisive point in time where her forefathers cemented a glorious revolution to claim civil and religious freedom for all peoples in these British Isles. And yet, for most of my lifetime, indeed, I felt almost afraid to visit the site of the famous battle, to tread the ground and indeed follow the footsteps of a king, his generals, his preachers like the Reverend George Walker, his brave soldiers, because I was unsure of the reception I might receive down there. Imagine the change that has unfolded before our eyes over the last couple of years. Those of you who attended the recent opening of the museum and interpretive centre at Oldbridge House and witnessed the convivial meeting of leading political figures from both parts of this island, of officers and brethren wearing orange regalia, greeting those of a different core belief to us, extending a hand of friendship to old opponents, whilst not compromising their firmly held faith and trust. Yes, it was a memorable event to behold. And I do hope that Oldbridge House and the resources it contains will become used by individual Orange men and lodges at all levels of the institution as a venue for visits, for meetings, for seminars, for conferences and such like, much as many of us used down Winter's Cottage in the past. The recent purchase of land within the battle site by our order was a progressive step, and all those involved in its purchase are to be congratulated on their forethought and ingenuity in that purchase, and none more than you, Brother Chairman. We as an institution thank you and your diplomatic involvement, along with a number of others, in the successful completion of that historic deal. And I do know that County Tyrone Grand Lodge were delighted to be a financial partner in that purchase. And I am sure other counties were as well. The recent announcement of grant aid by the Southern Government to fund the employment of a development worker and also to give money to help with lodges and hall repair and refurbishment has to be welcomed. And hopefully it will benefit you all here in the border counties. Please do take full advantage of it and use it for the people of Tyrone are in vision, with lodges here in Donegal as well as in Monaghan and Cavan, have been most beneficial to all who have taken part in them, and hopefully more of that type of thing can happen in the future. Yes, all of these developments have been good, positive signs that perhaps things are improving for our institution. And yet, we still see negative things within our communities. The continuing damage being written upon our Orange Halls on both sides of the border is so disappointing to us all. The intolerance of some communities towards our parades. The verbal bitterness of some of the critics who themselves have nothing positive to offer for a shared future together has beleaguered this institution for far too long. There must come a time for it to stop, and the sooner the better for us all. As members of this institution in the border counties have in the recent past gained confidence to stand firmly to uphold the values so bravely fought for and maintained over many previous generations, and you are to be applauded for your efforts. The resolutions before us today are the annual reminder of where we must stand in relation to our membership of the Loyal Orange Institution. First must come our personal faith in Christ, and I commend the thought-provoking address you have just heard from the Assistant Grand Master, Worshipful Brother the Reverend Alistair Smith. Secondly, our loyalty for the Crown and monarchy remaining Protestant, yes, even in this Republican part of the British Isles, is significantly important. And finally, for the country in which we live, be it Northern Ireland or indeed the Republic of Ireland, as an institution we have withstood much since its formation in 1795, and especially over these last 30 years. We will continue to stand firm for our beliefs in the future. We seek nothing more than civil and religious liberty for all and respect for our traditions and witness. Are you ready and willing to play your full part in your witness within your community? That is what the Christian Gospel and the Orange Institution is calling you to be and to do. Realize your potential and lay down the foundations for the Orange Order and all that we stand for to be relevant beyond our years. If you're here today and you're not a member of the Orange Institution, speak to somebody with a sash or collarette on and think about joining us. I have not for one moment regretted doing that almost 50 years ago, and I would sincerely hope you would not regret it either. We have a clear mission to commemorate our past, to expound the Protestant message, and to carry a torch for the future. That is the legacy we must hand to our young folk and to future generations as yet unborn. Am I up for it? I ask myself. Are you up for it? I ask each of you. Are we up for it? We should all ask ourselves. With God's help and strength, we should all hope and pray that the answer is yes. Brother Chairman, brethren, ladies and gentlemen, I have been delighted to be with you today, and I bring you the paternal greetings of the Grand Orange Lodge of Ireland, and also greetings of my own County Tyrone Grand Lodge, member of District Lodge, of which I'm proud to be master, and my own private lodge, Derry Pubble, LOL 49. And I again thank you for the invitation to attend and address this gathering at Rosnala. May you all, either as members or friends and supporters of our great institution in this part of the island, continue to be blessed, and it is my earnest prayer and hope that the great ideals and standards of the institution set before you by the work and determination of your forefathers as sisters and brethren here in County Donegal, and indeed in Monaghan, Cavan, Ireland, Leitrim, Dublin and Wicklow, continue to inspire you for even greater and better achievements and success in the future, so that the proud history and traditions, as well as the responsibilities given to you, can be handed down to the next and all future generations. Thank you, Wicklow Chairman, ladies.